what causes spiritual distraction. And I do have a subtitle, which is things that can distract us from God. In Matthew chapter 13, verse 15, Jesus told his followers that spiritual distraction begins with hearts that have grown dull, ears that are hard of hearing, and eyes that are closed. Please bow for prayer. Dear God, there is such great value in having time throughout each day when we can turn off the distractions of mind and heart and focus on you, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Please help us to turn off all the distractions around us and help us to focus only on you, Lord.
Yes.
May we have receptive hearts for your word today.
Yes, yes.
It's in Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Isn't it hard to keep focused on God? Many of us have tried so hard throughout our lives to stay focused on him. And we so often say, this time I won't fail. But at one point or another, something always comes up. And keeps us from exceeding.
Yes.
Why is that? I'm not sure, but I think it has to do with what we allow into our lives that can distract us from God. And not all of these things are bad in their nature. In fact, a lot of them are not, but they become a problem when we allow them to distract us from looking at God and looking to God. We live in a busy world, and it supplies us with endless distractions from our faith. And when we become distracted from our faith, we become separated from God. Think of your faith as a drive. Would you want to be in a car with a distracted driver? All kind of things can happen. You miss your exit. You can run off the road. And you can even take a wrong turn. It's no different in our faith. There are all kinds of spiritual distractions that take us on all kinds of wrong paths and far away from God. We can simply start with ourselves. We're human. And we tend to be very self-focused. And in other words, it's easy for us to get lost in our problems and ourselves to a point where we lose sight of God. And when we become too focused on ourselves, we are no longer focusing on God. Obviously, God loves us. And he wants us to care for ourselves, but he designed us for more than just to take care of ourselves. He also wants us to take care of one another and to love him. But no matter what we do, there will be a constant battle within ourselves between spirit and flesh. That is why we need to constantly allow God to search our hearts and purify it. The first step to overcoming ourselves is being aware. So don't let yourselves be your own spiritual distraction. Excuse me. What about social media? This is a problem, I would say, one of the biggest distractions for most people. It's so easy to get caught up in the media. And when I say media, I'm referring to TV, internet, cell phones, movies, video games,
you name it.
The media is so dangerous because it is so easy to get consumed in it. Now, everywhere we turn, there's some sort of media nowadays. Everywhere. And the worst part about it is it's littered with filth. TV and every advertisement on the internet, it's trying to convince us that we are missing something, and they are the one that can fill the need. Our young girls and women, we're bombarded by the media, and because they want to show us how we should look and how we should act. I mean, I could go on and on about the media and how distracting it is. Now, the key to overcoming the media is to be wise in what we watch, what we read and play, and in how much time we spend with it. We should always be willing to give it up. And quite honestly, some of the things that we indulge in, we need to give it up. Because if something is pure filth, we shouldn't be giving it any time anyway. It doesn't matter how funny, how cute it is.
That's right.
Now, money is a huge spiritual distraction. We all need it to live in this world, but we must not be owned by it if we are to be not of this world. Money itself is not an interference in our walk with God. The love of money is.
Yes.
And if we trust God, He will take care of us.
Yes, He will.
That doesn't mean that we should quit our jobs and not earn money. We just need to realize that God is more important and far more capable of taking care of us than we are, that is. Now, believe it or not, church or religion, that can interfere in our walk with God as well. And we can easily let it hinder our relationship with God. And the reason is, it's because it's so easy to pursue church and beliefs about God, but we forget to pursue God Himself. Okay? So it's so easy to go to church just to be going to church, when the real reason we should be going to church is to refuel for the week by coming together with fellow believers to worship and meditate on God. Excuse me. And somewhere along the way, people have gotten the idea that we need to pretend to be perfect at church. That, that if we show our weaknesses and our struggles, we'll become outcasts. And if one person does reveal their weaknesses, they're looked down upon. This is totally opposite of what church is supposed to be. Church is really the body of believers. We are supposed to help each other, pray for each other, and love one another.
Oh, yeah.
And to keep the church from becoming a distraction from God, make sure you are pursuing God before you pursue beliefs about Him. We need to get past religion and get into relationships. It starts with us. Love your brothers and sisters. Be open to people and do not condemn others when they fail. Can work and school be a spiritual distraction?
Yes.
Of course it can be. Some of us work. What a distraction. And I'm not only referring to a job, because thank God many of us are retired, and we still do so much, from worship to Bible study, prayer service, to so many other things. So many people go to school. So many people go to work. So many people go to work and school because it is an essential part of our lives, but we have to be careful not to let them distract us from our faith. Now, faith does not give us an excuse to quit school or not study, but to avoid the distractions that school or work can cause, we must be better at managing our time.
That's right.
We have to make sure we get done what we need to do on time so we can devote the time God needs. spiritual distractions are just caused by poor time management. And I'll repeat that. Some spiritual distractions are just caused by poor time management.
That's right.
Now, what can we say about our daily routine? Now, this is a common thing that I'm so guilty about, because I allow myself to get distracted a lot. But most of the time, it's for a good reason. And remember I said before that all distractions are not bad.
That's right.
The most important thing is that spending time with God should be in our daily routine.
That's right.
You know, far too often we just squeeze God in when we have downtime. I'm guilty. So it's so easy to get caught up in all the things that we have to do. Now, my husband is so disciplined. I didn't say perfect, but my husband is so disciplined when it comes to study, praying, and meditating. And I would like to share a little something with you. Before we retired, we both worked long hours. You know, we both worked for industry, two different locations. He worked outside, I worked inside. I would be so glad when Saturday morning would be here, because I wanted to be out and about. And Saturday was basically the only day that we had to do whatever we wanted to do. So, now keep in mind, we're talking about Saturday. He would get up real early, 3:30, 4 o'clock. And he goes into his study. I'm still in bed. Okay? I'll get up. When it's time for me to get up, I go and I say my prayers. Not pray. Say my prayers. And I read quickly. And I'm ready to go. I'm ready to get IHOP, Cracker Barrel, whatever. But he would still be in the study after hours of being in there. And even during the time when he would be on call, you know, Entergy call any time of morning, any time of night, and he'll get up before he leaves. He's gonna go in that study.
All right, now.
He's gonna pray.
He's
gonna read.
Yes.
And he's gonna meditate. And I'm like, okay, you know, it's about 2,000 people out of power. He's still in his study. Where is he going? You know, but I thank him for being so disciplined and for being such a good example. But guess what? It doesn't matter how disciplined he is. What I realize is that I have to know God for myself.
That's right.
I am 61 years old today, and I can't depend upon what Alton knows about God. I have to learn that. I have to do that. So there are so many spiritual distractions, and I'm going to share one more with you, and this is something that you probably won't believe, and I'm going to be very careful how I say this, but that spiritual distraction is our pastor. Well, he's not here. But now, to relieve you some, I'm speaking about all pastors, okay? And I'm referring to becoming totally dependent upon your pastor, okay?
Yeah.
And this could be a big interference in our walk with God. because it's not our pastor's responsibility to feed us all we need to be spiritually healthy. It is our responsibility. And a lot of people fall into the habit of giving God only Sunday or one Sunday per month. And this would be like eating, you know, once a week or eating once a month. And if we did this, we would certainly be malnourished. Okay? So, but sadly, this is the case for a lot of people spiritually. Now, our pastor, Lord, y'all all know he's a great leader.
Yes, he is.
Great leader. But that's all he should be.
Yeah.
And nothing more. Okay. So here we have several common things that can distract us from God. And it is a constant struggle to keep our eyes on Jesus and to not become distracted by the concerns and things of this world. You know, we are aware of what can and does interfere with our walk with God. And we can begin to take necessary action to prevent him. Now remember, Matthew chapter 6, verse 33 says, "Seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well." And before I take my seat, I would like to leave you with something. Don't let the noise of the world keep you from hearing the voice of the Lord. And I'll repeat that for you. Don't let the noise of the world keep you from hearing the voice of the Lord. Thank you.
Amen.
Father, thank you right now, Father, for the word, Father, and thank you for the word that we have deposited in our heart today, Father. That everything that we have and everything that we own is because of you, Lord, and we
have
told
us
on
you.
A lot of times we bring our problems to you, but Father, we need to come to our problems and bring you to our problems.